All right, so first and foremost, I want to give all praises to the Most High Yahweh, and we do so in the name of HaMashiach Yahweh Shah, and I pray that this lesson is further edifying to whoever it comes across. So today, I want to examine the Antichrist, the Son of Perdition, and the Mystery of Iniquity. At face value, these three terms seem to be talking about one specific individual. And due to this, there are many people that believe an anti-Messiah-like figure will show up in the last days with similar powers as the biblical Messiah, Yahweh Shah, but will work for the devil instead of the Father, Yahweh.
Crazy ad on me. I'll show you some crazy ad. Look at this. Come on, let's get busy.
And to further the ignorance, recently the imposter state claimed the Messiah had appeared in their country, which caused the Christian community to say this was the Antichrist.
He has prominent rabbis following him. You can see people just mobbed around him and kissing his hands and proclaiming miracles from this man. It's just crazy. I've never seen anybody followed like this in Israel. So this is significant. And this is very reminiscent of how the people followed Jesus.
But in reality, this was all a distraction. The Antichrist doctrine is illegitimate, and there has never been, nor will there ever be, a creation that is equal to or plays a counterpart to the Messiah. But to prove this claim, we will dissect various precepts used to establish the Antichrist doctrine in this video. And in the process, we will debunk it in less than 10 minutes. And Lord willing, whoever has ears to hear is further edified. So to start, the Strong Concordance defines the phrase Antichrist as an opponent or adversary of Yahweh Shah in general. And Philippians 3:18-19 shows us an enemy of Yahweh Shah can be someone who loves earthly things instead of spiritual things. With these two examples, we now understand that an Antichrist is more of a state of mind than a title. But to further the point, let's address the precepts. So 2 John 1:7, and it reads, "For many deceivers are entered into the world, who confess not that Yahweh Shah HaMashiach is come in the flesh. This is a deceiver and an antichrist." So here we see anyone who refuses to believe the Messiah came in the flesh is considered an antichrist. And as we all know, many people and religions don't believe in the Messiah, Yahweh Shah, which means there are currently millions of antichrists walking the earth right now, and there were millions who walked the earth before them. This would explain why the apostles were told there were already antichrists during their time in 1 John 2:18. Also, 1 John 2:22, and it reads, "Who is a liar but he that denieth Yahweh Shah is the HaMashiach? He is antichrist that denieth the Father and the Son." So after being told an antichrist is whoever denies the Son, we are now told that if you deny the Father, you fit this description as well. This is important because 1 John 5:10 tells us one way to not believe in the Father is to negate the record he gave of his Son. This means if you negate anything about the Messiah, including the dark skin he was said to have in Revelations 1:15 and his Hebrew name, Yahweh Shah, you are an antichrist. But now that we know an antichrist is anyone who is against the Father and Son, let's find out who the Son of Perdition represents. Now let's hit 2 Thessalonians 2:3-9, and it reads, "Let no man deceive you by any means, for that day shall not come, except there come a falling away first, and that man of sin be revealed, the son of perdition, who opposeth and exalteth himself above all that is called Yahweh, or that is worshipped, so that he as Yahweh sitteth in the temple of Yahweh, showing himself that he is Yahweh." So the Bible often calls entire nations a name or a word that will usually be used to represent one person. And this tends to throw most people off.
"May I help you?"
"We'll be asking the questions, old man. Who are you?"
"You."
"No, not me, you."
"Yes, I am you."
"Just answer the damn questions. Who are you?"
"I have told you."
"Are you deaf?"
"No, you is blind."
"I'm not blind, you blind."
"That is what I just said."
"You just said what?"
"I did not say what. I said you."
"That's what I'm asking you."
"And you is answering."
"Shut up! You!"
"Yes?"
"Not you, him! What's your name?"
"Me."
"Yes, you!"
"I am me."
"He's me, and I'm you."
"And I'm about to whoop your old ass, man, because I'm sick of playing games!"
For example, in Jeremiah 10:25, we see the words him, his, and Jacob used to represent the entire nation of Israel. With this being said, when the passage above says that man of sin and son of perdition, it's talking about a nation of people, not the Christian version of an antichrist. The passage also says this nation will view or exalt themselves above Yahweh. We know this is talking about the Edomites due to Isaiah 14:13 and Obadiah 1:3-4, telling us the Edomites will view themselves as an eagle and exalt themselves over the throne of the Most High, Yahweh. Also, when verse 4 says he sits in the temple of Yahweh, this represents the Edomite imposters that dwell in Jerusalem as we speak. So now that we know the son of perdition represents the Edomite bloodline, let's continue with verse 6 in 2 Thessalonians chapter 2. And now you know what withholdeth, that he might be revealed in his time. For the mystery of iniquity doth already work, only he who now letteth will let, until he be taken out of the way. So throughout the Bible, the Edomites are the only nation associated with both the terms mystery and iniquity. For example, Revelation 17 and 5 calls Babylon a mystery and associates it with iniquity through the word abomination. This is important because Psalms 137 and 7 through 9 shows the Edomites are who are in control of mystery Babylon. And with this being said, the mystery of iniquity is the revelation of the nation of Edom, which are now known as West Europeans. For proof, West Euros are the Edomites. Watch the video titled Esau Exposed, West Europeans and the Taklamakan Mummies. So now let's continue in 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, but we're going to hit verse 8 and keep it pushing. So verse 8, and it reads, "And then shall that wicked be revealed, whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of his mouth, and shall destroy with the brightness of his coming." So as many know, there is only one nation who the Father will destroy from the face of the earth, and that is the nation of Edom, as it is foretold in Isaiah 34 and 5, Psalms 52 and 5, and Obadiah 1 and 18. So when the verse above says the son of perdition will be destroyed, it's talking about the annihilation of Esau. And this is further proven when 2 Esdras 13 and 10 shows us the conclusion of the war between Esau and the Messiah that was foretold in Revelations 19 and 19. Also, we know some Edomites will be saved due to precepts like Romans 15 and 18 and Matthew 25, 31 through 46. But that's a lesson for another video. So let's keep moving forward and address the last verse of today's lesson. So verse 9 in the same chapter, and it reads, "Even him whose coming is after the working of Satan with all power and signs and lying wonders." Again, the only people who can fit this description is the nation of Edom, but let's further break it down. As we know, the beast in Revelations 19 and 20 represents NATO, and NATO is ran by Edomites. But this beast is also foretold to do wonders in the sight of men, like bringing fire down from heaven, as it is written in Revelations 13 and 13. And when we look into history, the Edomites brought fire down from heaven when they dropped 2 atomic bombs on Hiroshima and Nagasaki, Japan. With this being said, there is no other nation on earth that can fit the descriptions given in 2 Thessalonians 2 and 3 through 9 better than the descendants of Esau. Now that we've reached the end of the lesson, if you still think an Antichrist, man of sin, son of perdition, or mystery of iniquity has anything to do with the mythological white boy coming to the earth, you need to pull yourself together and go read that Bible.
Get your shit together! Get it all together and put it in a backpack, all your shit, so it's together! And if you gotta take it somewhere, you know? Take it to the shit store and sell it, or put it in a shit museum, I don't care what you do, you just gotta get it together! Get your shit together!
This lesson isn't to make anybody feel slow or dumb, but if you allow yourself to believe in lies, you might as well accept your level of ignorance. The Antichrist is a wicked mindset. The mystery of iniquity is the revelation of the son of perdition. And the son of perdition represents the nation of Edom. And with that being said, Lord willing, this was edifying to whoever had ears to hear. Shalom.